Hello friends, in today's tutorial, we would be learning how to create beautiful bicycle animations in PowerPoint presentations. Hello once again friends. One important thing to remember is that the basic fundamentals are the same for different versions of PowerPoint, be it 2007, 2010, 2013 or 2016 etc, both for Windows as well as for Mac. And with each new version, there are new and better features for the user's benefit. So first of all, let us see an example of what we are going to learn today. Friends, this is the beautiful bicycle animation which we are going to make. So let us proceed ahead and start learning. So here we are friends in the PowerPoint presentation. Now, in order to create such a beautiful bicycle animation in PowerPoint, there are a few steps which we need to follow. The first step is that we need to make these tires. The second step is that we need to make these round tubes. After that, we need to insert the handle and the handlebar. Then we need to insert the seat. And in the end, we need to insert the road. And finally, we need to animate this. So friends, let us start making all of these elements one by one. Let me first of all insert a blank slide, and then let me insert an oval shape first of all, like this. And then let me just click this oval shape and change the size of this oval to 2.1. Like this. Now, let us do some formatting for this oval. The shape fill should be white color, the shape outline should be black color, and we need to increase the width of this outline. So let me come over here, and for the purpose of this example, let me select the outline as 4.5 points, like this. Now let me insert another oval, and let me choose the size of this oval as 1.95. And for formatting for this oval, the shape fill should be white color, shape outline needs to be black color, and the weight, it can be 2.25 points, like this. And then let me select both of them, come over to the home button, and then arrange both of them, align middle and align center, like this. And then I need to do right click and group both of them so that it becomes one object. Now, after making the initial layout for the tire, let me insert a line within this tire from this point up till this point. And then after inserting this line, let me bring it outside, and then let me make 7 copies of this line by doing Ctrl C and then doing Ctrl V 7 times. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, the reason why we are making so many copies is that we need to make the spokes which are going to be used inside this tire. Now, let me select the second line and then let me rotate it by an angle of 30 degrees. Then let me select the second line and then rotate it by an angle of 60 degrees. For this line, let me rotate it by an angle of 90 degrees. For this line, let me rotate it by 120 degrees. For this, I need to rotate it by 150 degrees. For this particular line, I need to rotate it by 210 degrees. And for this line, I need to rotate it by 240 degrees. Like this. Now, I need to select all of these lines and then come over here to the arrange option and then align all of them in the middle and align all of them in the center, like this. And then I need to group all of them so that it becomes one object. Now, after grouping all of these lines, I just need to select all of these elements, that is the lines as well as the tire, and then I need to again arrange all of them, align center and align middle, so that These lines now represent the spokes for the tire. And then I need to group all of these together so that this whole becomes one element now. Now friends, we have made one tire of the bicycle. Now we need to just make a copy of this and make the second tire. But before that, let me come over here to the view option and then let me select these guides as well as the grid lines. And now let me bring this tire a little bit here so that it superimposes on this particular line like this. And then let me just make a copy of this tire by doing Ctrl C and then doing Ctrl V. Now let me just bring this tire somewhere here in order to make the initial layout for the cycle like this. Now friends, after inserting the tires, I need to insert these kind of red round tubes. So let me come back to my slide and then let me first of all insert a line which starts from the center of this tire and goes up till here. Now let me just select this line and make some changes to its length like this. And then let me bring this particular starting point of the line towards the center of this circle like this. Now let me do some formatting for this line by selecting this, then coming over to the shape outline, selecting the color, then selecting the thickness of this line, that is 6 points for the purpose of this example. And then let me just do right click, come over here to the size and position option, and then rotate this line by minus 22 degrees like this. And then let me just bring this line here so that the starting point is superimposing on the center of this particular tire. Now friends, after making the first line, let me just make a copy of this by doing Ctrl C and Ctrl V, and then let me bring this line all over here like this. And then let me again rotate this line, and this time I'm going to rotate it by minus 18 degrees. There is a little bit change in the angle, and then let me bring this line somewhere here like this. Now I need to make the remaining elements of the cycle. So let me just copy this line by doing Ctrl C and Ctrl V, and then bringing this line all over here and making some changes like this and like this. So this is the top handlebar of the cycle. And then let me again do Ctrl V and then bring this line all over here and just connect this line to this point like this. And then the next step is I again do Ctrl V to create another line, and then I bring this line here and I connect this particular line to somewhere this point like this. Now at this point it is not essential that we join both of these together, as you will be able to see later on. But for now, let me just make another copy of this line and then let me bring this particular line here and join this point with this particular line like this. Now friends, the initial layout of the cycle is complete. In the next step, I again need to insert an oval shape, and this time the size of the oval shape should be 0.5. Like this. And then let me just do some formatting. The shape fill should be white color and the shape outline should be black color. And then let me bring this oval shape all the way here like this. And then this particular area represents the region where the pedal of the cycle would be moving. Now the next step is to make the handlebar. For that I again need to select this line, do Ctrl C and Ctrl V in order to make a copy, and then let me make it horizontal like this. And then let me just make the length of this handlebar to be 0.5 like this. And then let me bring this line all the way here, and then The next step is to add a curved handlebar like this one. So let me come back here. And for adding this curved handlebar, I come over here to the shapes menu and insert a particular type of a shape, which is known as the block arc. Now, let me just select this and make the size as 0.6 and 0.6. And then let me just rotate it by 90 degrees. And as far as the color is concerned, let me select this, and the shape fill should be the same color as the handle, and for the shape outline, I don't need any outline. Now, let me just increase the length of this line by a little bit margin. Let us say I make it as 0.7, and then let me bring this handlebar all the way here, like this, and rotate it a little bit. Now friends, the next step is that I need to add the seat to the cycle. For adding the seat, let me again insert an oval shape. And then let me change the size of this oval to 0.6:1, like this. Now, let me bring this oval shape close to this line, like this. And then let me make a copy of this oval shape, and then bring this oval shape all the way towards the top. Now, let me make some changes to this oval. Let me take it towards the right by 2 points and then down by 2 points. And then my purpose is that I need to subtract this particular oval from this oval. So I select both of these ovals, come over here to the combine shapes options and do shape subtract like this. And then I just make some changes to the size. I need to make this particular size to be 0.3. So this is now resembling a seat, which I can place here on the bicycle. And then let me do the shape fill of this seat as black color and shape outline as no outline, like this. Now friends, as you can see here, that we have been able to create a beautiful looking bicycle. Now, in order to animate this bicycle, I need to insert a road, and then I need to animate this bicycle as well as the road in order to create a beautiful effect. For that, let me insert a new slide just for making the road. Now, I need to come over here to the shapes menu and insert a rectangle. Now, the width of this rectangle needs to be 0.3, like this, and it should be covering the entire slide. For the purpose of this example, let me select the shape fill for this road to be green color, and I don't need any shape outline, so I select no outline. And then I select this road and do a copy of this and bring it all the way here towards the top, like this. And then I need to insert another shape of a line, which is in between the middle of these two rectangles, and it extends from one side of the slide to another. And as far as the formatting for this line is concerned, let me select this. The shape outline needs to be black, and the weight of the road needs to be 6 points. And then, in order to give it a more realistic effect of the road, I need to again select this, come over here to the shape outline, and select this option of long dash for the road. Now, after making all of these elements, I need to do Control A to select all of them and then group them so that it becomes one element. And then let me just rearrange this. And for better understanding, now let me just reduce the size of the slide. And then I need to make a copy of this road by doing Control C and Control V. And then I need to bring this particular copy towards the end, like this. And then I need to select both of them once again and group them. Now friends, the road is also ready. So let me just do Control C to copy this, come back to my main slide, and then do Control V, like this. And then let me just increase the size. And then I need to send this road towards the back. Now friends, we have made the bicycle, we have made the road. So let me come over here to the view option and remove these guides as well as the grid lines, like this. Now, the next step is that I need to animate all of these elements. So first of all, I need to animate these tires. So I select both of them, come over here to the animations tab, and then select a particular animation of a spin animation, like this. And then let me just rotate this tire a little bit just to give it a better effect. And now let me select both of these tires and come over to the animations pane. The first tire should be spinning on click with the duration of 2 seconds, that is okay. And the second tire should be starting with previous. So now let me just do double click and come over to the effects options. And as far as the timing is concerned, I've already selected a timing of 2 seconds, and for repeating, it should be repeating until the end of the slide. And similarly for the second tire also, it should be repeating until the end of the slide, like this. Now, as far as the animation for the road is concerned, I need to add a particular type of an animation of a line animation, like this. But the default direction you can see is towards the bottom, which I need to change. So let me just reduce the size, and then let me bring over this arrow towards the end of the slide, like this. And as far as the animation properties are concerned, it should be starting with previous. The duration of this animation can be 4 seconds for the purpose of this example. And let me come over to the effects options. I don't need a smooth start, I don't need a smooth end. And for the timings, it should be repeating until the end of the slide. And then let me press OK. Now, after adding the animations, let me just increase the size for better understanding. And then let us do some minor modifications inside this cycle so that it makes a beautiful animation. So let me first of all select this line and extend it a little bit like this. And then let me select this particular line and then extend it like this. And now let me just save this presentation by doing Ctrl S, and then let us play this slideshow from the current slide. So here we are, friends. Now let me press the enter button, and you can see here that we have been able to create a beautiful bicycle animation in PowerPoint. So now let me press the escape button and come back. So friends, we are back in the PowerPoint slide. In today's tutorial, we have been able to learn how to create beautiful bicycle animations in PowerPoint presentations. I hope that you have enjoyed this small video. In case you have any questions, comments or suggestions, then please mention them in the comments box below. And do subscribe to our channel so that you can have the latest updates regarding all our videos. Once again, thank you so much for watching this video, and I would be uploading a new video soon. Bye for now. Friends, in order to watch all my latest videos, do subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button. And do click this bell icon to get notifications whenever I publish a new video.